Will be forever. Please join me in singing, "Be Not Afraid."
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
My name is Father Phil Schultz. I'm a priest from the Archdiocese of Morelia, Michoacán, Mexico. Yo soy el Padre Felipe, vengo de la Arquidiócesis de Morelia, Michoacán, México. It's important for us today, as we're gathered together, to recognize that we are celebrating this funeral mass for Pope Sixt. As I mentioned to the family before we came in, I underscore that word celebrate, because for us, humanly speaking, separation is always difficult. But for him, reunited with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, La Santísima Virgen de Guadalupe, he is truly celebrated because we believe in the mercy of God. You're all welcome at Saints Peter and Paul Parish. I'm the administrator here, and I want to underscore that you are welcome, because this is not only God's house, this is also our house. Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, present in the tabernacle, always awaiting us with open arms. Es decir, esta casa no es solamente la casa de Dios, esta casa también es nuestra. Porque nuestro Señor Jesucristo presenta. sacramentalmente en el sagrario, siempre esperándonos con sus brazos abiertos. Before we begin Mass, after welcoming you, I just want to make sure that everyone feels comfortable during the Mass. I recognize that not everyone here is Catholic. We have different gestures as Catholics during Mass. For instance, at this time, you are seated, as you will frequently be during the Mass. You are seated to listen and to learn. To listen to the Word of God and to learn. Jesus, during his public life, frequently spoke and the people were seated. Yeah, they were seated to listen to his teachings. At other times, during the public life of Jesus, people approached him, and out of humility, they prostrated themselves. Yeah. That was a sign of humility. Now, we don't have enough space in our church for all of us to prostrate ourselves. So as a sign of humility, we kneel. We sit to listen and to learn from the Word of God. We kneel as a sign of humility. And finally, for us today, the last gesture is extremely important. There are other moments in the Mass when we all stand. It's a reminder of the resurrection of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Este cielo durante la misa hoy, a veces vamos a estar aquí sentados. Cuando estamos sentados, sentados para escuchar y aprender. En otros momentos vamos a estar de rodillas, sí, de rodillas, con un signo de humildad, que reconocemos que nuestro Señor es todopoderoso. Y por último, también hay momentos cuando vamos a andar de pie, si parados, como un recuerdo de la resurrección de nuestro Señor Jesucristo. The day of his baptism, Jose was invited to participate in the resurrection of Christ. And precisely for that reason, we have the Paschal candle here, the Easter candle. The Paschal candle is lit on Holy Saturday, the first Mass of the Resurrection. It's a reminder of the Passion, the death, and the Resurrection of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. His parents and godparents lit a candle from the Easter candle the day of his baptism. Yeah. That was a reminder that he was called from that very moment to be like Jesus Christ. It's light for the world that walked in darkness. So that's why the Easter candle is present. In addition, in just a few moments, I'm going to bless his ashes with holy water. And just like those waters of baptism, another reminder of his invitation to participate in the resurrection. Este cierre ahorita antes de iniciar la misa para entender bien cómo andamos. Primero, aquí tenemos el cirio pascual. El cirio pascual es un recuerdo de la pasión, la muerte y la resurrección de nuestro Señor Jesucristo. Desde el momento del bautizo, José estaba invitado a participar en la resurrección de nuestro Señor. Este cirio es un recuerdo, no solamente de esta invitación, pero también él estaba invitado a ser como Jesús, luz para el mundo que ande en tinieblas. Y por eso sus padrinos y sus papás encendieron una vela en el cirio pascual. También en unos momentitos voy a bendecir sus cenizas con agua bendita. Un recuerdo de las aguas del bautizo. Es decir, del bautizo que recibí. Are there any questions or any doubts before encantos. Es importante recordar que esta señora y su esposo no están aquí para entretenernos, están aquí para ayudarnos a alabar a Dios. In your pews, you'll find hymnals. We ask you to use the hymnals because our two musicians today are not here to entertain us. They're here to help us praise God. Would you all please stand? And we begin, as we begin all good things, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. As our brother Jose has died with the Lord, so may he live with him in glory. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I ask you to all join your voices in song, singing hymn number
439.
439.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the
reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men, indeed, they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. as gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love. Because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. When Jesus arrived in Bethany, he found that Lazarus had already been in the tomb for 4 days. Now Bethany was near Jerusalem, only about 2 miles away. And many of the Jews had come to Martha and Mary to comfort them about their brother. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she sent to meet him. But Mary sat at home. Martha said to Jesus, "Lord, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now, I know that whatever you ask of God, God will give you." Jesus said to her, "Your brother will rise." Martha said to him, "I know he will rise in the resurrection on the last day." Jesus told her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Whoever believes in me, even if he dies, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord. I have come to believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, the one who is coming into the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. The biblical account that we heard today from the Gospel of St. John is found only in St. John's Gospel. Let's just go back to the times of Jesus and remember that throughout his public life, Jesus was always en route to Jerusalem, always en route to his passion and death, because his purpose here on earth was to resurrect from the dead. The way that he could prove that he was the Messiah, the Christ, the anointed one of the Father. So, what we find is Jesus was en route to Jerusalem. And while en route, he was in a small village near Bethany. We're not certain exactly what the village was called. Some of his closest friends during his life here on earth were Lazarus and his two sisters, Martha and Mary. All right. Lazarus became gravely ill. Martha and Mary, trusting in Jesus, trusting that he was the Messiah, sent a messenger to inform him that their brother was gravely ill, with the hopes that Jesus would be able to save him. However, Jesus was delayed in the small village where he was, and did not arrive in Bethany until 2 days after Lazarus had been laid in the tomb. Yeah. That's the reality of our reading today. Jesus' arrival after the death of Lazarus. Okay, with that reality, Jesus enters, and Martha, initially upset with Jesus, "If you had been here, my brother would not have died. But even now, I trust in you. Whatever you ask of your Father will be done." Had we continued on with the reading, yes, we would have seen that Jesus physically resurrected Lazarus from the dead. We're all familiar with this history, the resurrection of Lazarus from the dead. This was such a significant event in the life of Jesus that the Pharisees, who were constantly frustrated with Jesus, now Jesus had resurrected Lazarus from the dead, now there was no doubt, none whatsoever, that he was the Messiah, that he was the Christ, that he was the Son of God. And precisely for that reason, Jesus had to suffer his passion and death on the cross so that he could resurrect. So, as we're gathered here together today, we could also stop and think about Hosea, Priego. We could think about the fact that he also had a deep friendship with our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And if Jesus had resurrected Lazarus because of their close friendship, out of compassion, couldn't we ask that same thing for Jose, for Pedro? But the fact is, all of us that are gathered here today want the best for him. Isn't that a fair statement? Isn't that a fair statement?
Yes.
And the best for him is not a physical resurrection here on earth. The best for him is a spiritual resurrection, to be intimately united with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and our Blessed Mother. So today, we have to thank God for the gift of his life. But we also have to thank God for the gift of eternal life, which is offered to each one of us. And ask God, in his mercy, to receive Jose into his open arms. Nosotros acabamos de escuchar el Santo Evangelio según San Juan. Es Juan el único de los cuatro evangelistas que nos da esta historia. Recordamos que Jesús, durante su vida pública, siempre estaba en camino a Jerusalén. ¿Por qué? Porque en Jerusalén sufriría su pasión y su resurrección. Pasión, muerte y resurrección. Ok, pensando en su vida pública, vemos en la lectura hoy que Jesús estaba en un pueblito cerca de Betania. En Betania, sus mejores amigos, Lázaro, Marta y María. Lázaro se puso muy grave y precisamente por eso Marta y María mandaron mensajeros para avisar a Jesús que su hermano estaba grave, precisamente con las esperanzas que Jesús podría curar, sanar a Lázaro. Pero Jesús llegó después de la muerte de Lázaro, eran 4 días después de la muerte, ya estaba sepultado. Nosotros reflexionamos sobre eso. Jesús llegando, pero ya estaba muerto. Marta recibió a Jesús y dijo, Señor, si hubieras estado aquí, mi hermano no hubiera muerto. Pero aún así, confío en ti. Nosotros sabemos, siguiendo la lectura del Santo Evangelio, que Jesús resucitó corporalmente a su buen amigo Lázaro. Lo hizo por misericordia. Sí, misericordiosamente se levantó, resucitó a Lázaro. Nosotros aquí reconocemos también que por la resurrección de Lázaro, Jesús tuvo que sufrir su pasión y muerte para resucitar. Pasión y muerte porque los fariseos, su paciencia se acabó.
Sí.
Porque ¿quién puede resucitar a un muerto? Solamente Dios.
Sí.
Y ya no hubo duda. Jesús, verdadero hombre y verdadero Dios. Por eso los fariseos se acabaron su paciencia. Hoy nosotros pensamos sobre José, sobre el Prieto. Él también llevaba mucha amistad con Jesús. Nosotros también podemos o pudiéramos pedir el favor de una resurrección corporal. Todos estamos aquí y todos queremos lo mejor para Él. Lo mejor para Él no es una resurrección corporal, más bien una resurrección espiritual. Entonces hoy imploramos la misericordia de Dios. Damos gracias a nuestro Señor por su vida aquí en la tierra. Por su misericordia, pedimos a nuestro Señor que le da la vida eterna a José. Please stand. Trusting in God's unlimited love for each one of us and for Jose, we present our petitions to him. To each petition, we'll all respond, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for Jose, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for all of our deceased relatives and friends, and all who have helped us, that they may have the reward for their goodness. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all of the family and friends of Jose, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and eternal Father, we thank you for all of your gifts, but especially that great gift of your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, and his invitation to participate in his resurrection. Deepen our love for you so that we can always accept your holy will. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
Join me in singing Beyond the Morning Stars, number 48.
Just sing your glory.
sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good, the good of all his holy church. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant, Jose, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Heavenly Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, and the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise, as we all acclaim. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, David, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Pietro, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he, who is united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Please stand. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to sing. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Llenos de alegría de ser llamados hijos de Dios, digamos confiadamente la oración que Cristo nos enseña. Padre nuestro, que estás en el cielo, santificado sea tu nombre. Venga a nosotros tu reino. Hágase tu voluntad en la tierra como en el cielo. Danos hoy nuestro pan de cada día. Perdona nuestras ofensas, como también nosotros perdonamos a los que nos ofenden. No nos dejes caer en la tentación y líbranos del mal. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of this Christ be with all of you. Please exchange a sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
This is Jesus.
We recognize that this belief is unique to the Catholic Church. So for all of those who are non-Catholics or who have not gone to confession recently, but would like to come forward, you can come forward and receive a blessing simply by putting your hands on your shoulders like this. And I'll be happy to give you a blessing. Thank you for your understanding.
Thank you.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother Jose. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. This time I will now incense the urn, the ashes. Just as incense rises, so our prayers rise to heaven. You would continue in silent prayer while I'm incensing the casket. Our cantor will continue in song. Signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with all the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and our brother Jose forever. We ask this through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
May the angels lead you into paradise, O Savior. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. Amen. On behalf of the family, I want to thank all of you for your presence, your participation in this Mass. Your presence here today is a great consolation for them. They would like to invite all of you to a luncheon gathering which will be held at the golf course, which is directly down Oak Street, that is to say, County Trunk M. It will be on your left-hand side. You'll see a sign for the golf course if you're not familiar with it. There will be an opportunity for all of you to share some time and some reflections with the family. But once again, thank you very much for your participation. And in the name of our risen Lord and Savior, let us go forth to love and to serve. Thanks be to God.
Please join in singing our closing song, Blue Eagle's Wings, number 4.